this time on Kim's Rude Awakenings, the good family.
April?
Four kids, five dogs, wall-to-wall clutter.
Well, what kind of joke is this?
The family is frustrated.
You're not happy about Miss Aya.
Darn tootin'.
But the good's big issue is that they blame each other for the mess.
She's the mother, and the mom should clean the house.
I think they're a bunch of spoiled brats.
It's time for the blame game to end.
It's a dump!
And for Kim Woodburn and Mike Shalhoub to wake these people up.
Young girl!
Let's go.
Zombie.
Yes, come on, zombie.
Britain's Queen of Clean, Kim Woodburn, has taken the trip across the Atlantic to meet lifestyle expert Mike Shalhoub for a very special assignment. Their mission, to identify, confront, and rehabilitate messy, disorganized families who've lost their sense of pride. This episode, Kim and Mike are sorting through the issues of the good family, comprising of Mom Marika, Dad Dave, and kids April, Joe, Gordy, and Gavin. For 3 years, the goods have been living in what looks like a lovely suburban home, but looks can be deceiving. Step inside and you see piles of laundry and random junk everywhere. Go upstairs and you'll find the most awkward sleeping arrangements imaginable, which is why April has turned her family in for a rude awakening, because living in this mess has become unbearable.
I'm late all the time, and that's also embarrassing because you're always late, which stems from the fact that everything's disorganized.
Mom! Your lunch is on the table!
Mom can't keep up with things on her own, and it seems like she's given up on her home in favor of the dogs.
Just do the laundry, just do the dishes. She doesn't have time for that anymore because of the dogs.
I say it's the dogs 100%.
In the eyes of her family, this makes Marika responsible for the mess.
I get the blame all the time. It is always my fault, no matter what it is.
But Dad and the kids aren't babies. They're old enough to pick up after themselves, but they won't. Instead, they expect Marika to do the work for them.
She's the mother, now she's an at-home mom. An at-home mom should clean the house.
And really, that's the good family's big issue. Everybody blames everybody else for the mess. But the goods need not fret, because Kim and Mike are about to surprise them with a very rude awakening.
Good morning, good family. It's time to clean your ass up.
This house is a mess, and so are your sleeping arrangements.
You never help your mother each time you pitched in.
Rise and shine, good family. This is your rude awakening.
Pick up that light.
Let's go.
This time in the morning.
You come back here again, you can kiss my Canadian.
I have no desire to kiss your Canadian anything. Get out of my way. You're such a rude man. Come on. What's here? Well, I'm not too happy about this lot. Clothes, knock. Shoes all over the hall. You're not happy about this, are you?
I'm tootin'.
Nobody helps Mom keep things clean. So rather than being everyone's maid, she's letting Dad and the kids fend for themselves.
I think they're a bunch of spoiled brats, and they're very jealous that I am now paying attention to my doggies and not to them individually all the time.
Children and husband come first, doggies come second.
Second.
How bad have things become? Well, the kitchen is just the start of this fairy tale gone wrong.
This place is terrible. You've got pans days old. You've got all, look at the grease. Your sink's dirty. You've got garbage here. It's a dump! The kids blame you, you blame them. The husband blames everybody. Now, lovey, somebody's got to take the initiative and clean this dump up.
It is nobody's priority, so why should it be mine?
Oh, now, this has got to be some kind of a flaming joke, has it? You keep your hands to yourself.
I'm just saying.
Who's better?
Well, your bed's a little organized.
He sleeps with you in your bed.
No,
he
sleeps in my bed.
So he won't clear the top. So you leave in your bed. Well, where do you go?
I sleep in my mom's bed.
Oh, isn't she a lucky woman? Where do you sleep?
I sleep in my bed sometimes.
When you don't sleep in that bed, Where do you sleep?
Sometimes I sleep with my mom, but that's about it. Just anywhere.
He's in mother's bed. You're in mother's bed. How big's the bed? And where's your father?
So this is mom and dad's room.
I expected a huge bed, you know. Since the whole family sleeps now, one time or the other. I have to ask you something. Where do you sleep, dear?
Now that's kind of personal, but,
I'm not inviting you to sleep in my bed. Don't get carried away, love. Well, you're not getting an offer.
You never know.
You thought he was married to me. He's actually married to the TV.
You know, you're very young to equip the wife, aren't you?
This family is falling apart. Kim and Mike need to formulate a plan.
Do you know, they're a smashing family, aren't they, but disorganized. I mean, I've never seen clutter like it.
And where do they sleep with all those clothes everywhere?
Every one of them are disorganized.
We've got to get everyone to do individual jobs and make each person feel important and feel that they have a role to do. You take Mother Bear and get her organized with all the laundry. I'll take the boys and I'll get their rooms organized so they have proper time management, and this whole family will be spot on. After you, my darling. No problem. Watch for the dogs you do.
The kids need to understand why Mom is so frustrated and prefers the dogs.
April! Gordy! What are you doing? Gavin! Did you get in the car?
Time for the switch.
Tomorrow morning, we're switching roles. You kids are getting up at 7:30. Mother's going to have a break.
7:30.
Stop it, I've warned you.
So wait, do we have to be awake at 7:30?
Wake up, man.
Switching roles is gonna be tough. Yeah. But getting up by 7:30 a.m., Mike and Kim might be asking for the impossible. Domestic diplomats Kim Woodburn and Mike Chaloux have infiltrated the Good Family Disaster Zone.
It's a dump!
After hiking through the mess, Kim and Mike have identified the root of the problem. The Good Family loves to play the blame game.
The kids blame you, you blame them. The husband blames everybody.
So now Kim and Mike are going to give Mom a break from her daily routine and put the kids to work.
Get in the sink for me, please.
Tomorrow morning, we're switching roles. You kids are getting up at 7:30. Mother's going to have a break. A well-earned one, in my opinion.
7:30
a.m.
I don't want to hear one now. I want a yes, Mum. It'll be a first, but yes, Mum will do me.
So wait, do we have to be awake at 7:30?
Oh, shut up.
So get down there and start treating her like the queen. Remember, yes, Mom. Yes, Mom.
Come on.
Skip them up there.
I bet you the girl won't get up. Women are funny, you know.
April may have nominated her family for their rude awakening, but she can't even get out of bed.
Now. April,
come on. Be careful what you wish for, April.
Sit down. Mom, delegate.
I would like Gavin and Gordy, if you could make me a nice hot breakfast, maybe a little bit of fresh fruit.
Yes, Mom.
Yes, Mom.
April.
Joe Perry.
You guys are on dog duty.
Dog poop cleanup, Joe Perry.
Feeding the little munchkins, fluffing up their little blankies.
That's
in the crates.
A bit too much for my liking.
Yes, Mom.
Okay. Yes, Mother.
Thank you. Okay, gentlemen, this is gonna be fun, sloppy cooking, but we're gonna do a very good job for your mother. Don't make a mess. Wait, so the garbage doesn't go there. The garbage goes in the garbage.
But it's not real small, right?
Fluff up my dog's freaking blankets.
Well, it's taking longer than I thought. I thought it was just put it in, it's done. And then there's drinks, set up the table. Plus, she's gonna do lunches and breakfast. Taking my mom differently now.
Kind of think of her differently too.
A lot of the times we're really lazy and we don't want to go outside. But, you know, if I guess my mom can take the time to do it, plus all the other things she does, then, you know, maybe we can do it to help her out a little bit too.
I appreciate it a lot more, for sure.
Isn't that beautiful?
And voila! And now serve your mother?
Wow. They've never served me like this before. Oh, it looks scrumptilicious.
Oh, my goodness.
See the nice round of applause.
Your brothers.
Nice.
Well done.
I have goosebumps. I'm just so touched.
You don't give kids credit. They think an awful lot, you know.
Yeah.
Oh, dear.
Mom is happy. But now, this family needs to get the rest of their house in order. Let's see where the blame falls this time.
Do you know what worries me? The washing! 80% of the problem in this house is your washing. Organization, like each one of you each day, you go out that door, you run down to the basement, and you put laundry in the laundry room. Right? Great.
I don't do laundry.
Here you go. This is a laundry basket. You've got three compartments. Whites, colors. Pale colours, darks. Go on, do your best. You won't get it all in, it's your own fault. I can't say any more. I've said all I can say. Darks. Oh, I wasted your time. Let's get out of the devil. I've never seen them so excited over laundry. It's full. But if you keep the washing down, you've got plenty of room in here. By Jove, you got it! Be messy, don't you?
Oh, it's atrocious.
Just sit down a minute, lovely. I've got something to talk about. Oh, there's a bit of an over today. Somebody's got naughty feet, haven't they?
Oh, goodness.
Yes. Right. Here's these. This is going to shock me, I tell you. Nice shoes, leather. Quite clean, just need a polish. There. A bit whiffy. Easily solved. Plastic bags, lovely. Now. You might get bigger or smaller, it depends how big the feet are. Let's see if this fits in here. If it doesn't, well, we'll have to get bigger ones. I want you to take that, put it in your freezer.
In my freezer?
Mm. Yes. For the night. But imagine you're big and do it properly. What happens is, the freezer, it's so cold, it kills bacteria in the shoe. It also, when the bacteria is killed, kills the odour. It's the bacteria that's stinking. Therefore, the smell's gone.
The goods love to blame each other for the mess, but they're all responsible for hoarding too much useless stuff. Kim and Mike have a remedy for the situation, but it's gonna require the use of some heavy artillery.
Now, family, I want you to go in the house, and I want you to pick an object out that is useless, never gets used, never will get used, and we're gonna throw it out.
And we're gonna give you 2 minutes to do it. Oh. Ready, set, go!
The goods have accepted Kim and Mike's challenge to find the most useless objects in their house.
20 seconds!
But are they all on the same page? Let the blame game begin again.
This is the first time I've seen her sit in this chair since we got it.
It's my chair.
And Kim discovers the dogs aren't the only animals in this house. The Good family loves to play the blame game.
Somebody's got to take the initiative and clean this dump up.
It is nobody's priority, so why should it be mine?
But after switching roles, they're starting to realize that blaming each other is good for no one.
Think of my mom differently now.
20 seconds, 18.
Now Kim and Mike have got the whole family racing against the clock to locate their most useless items and get them out of the house.
Here we go.
Come on.
5 more seconds. And perfect. Here we are.
Why are you sitting on, why did that chair come out? Would you please be quiet when I'm speaking? Why are you sitting on that chair? Was it brought out here?
Well, because my family wants to be rid of it. It's my chair.
I don't think that it matches anything in the house, and it really smells bad.
Well, your mother clearly uses the chair, no?
This is the first time I've seen her sit in this chair since we've got it.
You've gotten away with murder, you four. The way you wind your mother around your finger. Oh, look at that little face. Look at that cheeky face. Do you want this chair, lovey?
Yes,
I do. It shall be yours.
Mom can keep her chair for now, but Kim's got a plan to get rid of the rest of this junk for good.
Come on, Mike!
Come on! Yeah!
Eventually, the whole family is seeing the bigger picture. Decluttering creates much-needed space in a messy house, and besides, most of this stuff is just broken and useless anyway. By clearing out their basement, the goods have significantly increased the amount of space available. So, they're getting some carpet laid and creating a new room downstairs. Mike is already making plans for it.
Tell me what's going on in this room that makes it so chaotic.
Everything goes on in here. There's always eating, there's sleeping, constant homework all night long.
Gavin, what time do you go to bed? Tell me the truth.
2.
2 a.m. And how old are you?
10.
10. So when Gavin goes to sleep, we're still working in here and doing stuff. So how is your little brother supposed to sleep? He's not. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna find an appropriate place in this house to organize and to do all your homework in. This is strictly gonna be a bedroom.
Mike's idea? Move homework to the basement. And he's already staked his claim there.
This is going to be the good family home office center, okay?
Wicked.
Good?
Yeah.
But this house still has some major cleaning problems.
I'm looking at this carpet. God help us. Don't hair shop on dark carpets. Now, we've got tape. The good old parcel tape. We're putting it on, my love. Back to front. When the woman can get it right. Get on your knees, get on your knees. I'd love to see a man on his knees. Get on those knees. Mm-hmm. Now, let's work. Now, go down in straight lines. Look, 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 look.
Oh, smokes.
Now, you cannot tell me.
Get that
corner. Go on, get the corner.
That's unbelievable.
Don't you think that's incredible?
That's more than incredible.
Now, no more of this, my good man. Pull yourself together, for goodness sake. Now, you take those. Put them on. No, you don't want hairs all through your fingernails. No, you don't want them. Honestly, it's super. It's just water. And honestly, I'm just gonna moisten the rubber glove. And then what I do is, I run it down the chair, and it absolutely picks up all the hairs. It gathers in a clump, you see. There's about 100 hairs there. It gathers in a massive clump. Oh, stop, that's just sissy. Let's see what you can get. Right, go on. I like to come up because I think you're gathering. I think you're gathering when you come up. That's what I think. Oh, God help us. Oh, God help us.
Oh, don't smell it. Oh, God! It's disgusting!
The constant blaming is starting to slow, and the house is shaping up. The goods are actually making some progress.
Let's make the bed. Permanent.
Let's see if they're up for the final challenge.
You've been very good with what you've thrown out. There's a lot left. You've got 24 hours to organize a lawn sale.
It's probably better called a junk sale.
Well, people do buy junk, dear.
And there's a little catch. All the people that are going to be coming to this yard sale will be supplied with
refreshments. Any advice you need, this is the man to ask.
You have 24 hours.
So, better go to it.
Yeah.
Wait a second. A yard sale with refreshments? If the goods can pull themselves away from their fun and games for a while,
yeah,
they might be able to make it happen.
Oh, hey, how's it going?
Oh, this family doesn't stand a chance.
Hey, boys, where you going?
Since their arrival, Kim Woodburn and Mike Chaloux have been pushing the good family to stop blaming each other.
I think they're a bunch of spoiled brats.
And start taking responsibility for their own mess.
What a lovely floor you've got. See, I didn't know your floor was this nice.
Now the goods are facing their biggest challenge yet. Come together as a family and sell off the rest of their unwanted items in a yard sale.
The rule is, it's not going back in the house. I'm warning you, it's not going back.
Oh, come on down to our lawn sale. Put on by my good friends from the cleanup show. Oh, hey, how
what are you doing?
I'm trying to draw up some customers for my lawn sale that you put me out here for. Woo-hoo! Come on. Buy some toys, boys. You get free lemonade. Hey, come on down to the good old sale.
What are you looking for? Dogs? Want a dog?
That's a pretty good deal.
David's even offering a home delivery service.
Would you like me to carry it to your house? Okay, we have four strong boys here.
Wow, the goods are really pulling together.
Well, that's free.
No. $10 for the woman and the man.
Marika's even learning to let go. And has put her beloved chair up on the auction block.
It's my favorite chair, I must say. But now that I know it's going to a good home, thank you so much, Kim.
It's organized well. It's organized very well.
Like it. It looks nice.
And just so no one forgets where they've come from in such a short time, Kim and Mike have prepared photographs of how things looked before they came.
We call this the wall of shame, and the shame is no more.
That is absolutely disgusting.
Oh, I'm so embarrassed.
The basement was like a cold, barren cell. Now it's the perfect place for homework and personal research. With some of the proceeds from the yard sale, the goods living room has been completely transformed.
Have you seen anything like this?
The boys' bedroom has been transformed to a place where Joe, Gordy, and Gavin can finally get some sleep.
Wow.
Happy?
Very.
Great.
And Marika and Dave's bedroom has been revived from a tattered mess to a peaceful and inviting love shack that is now open for business.
This. Oh, this is good. I miss you.
It looks great in here now.
And I'm favorite is boudoir, isn't it?
Get out.
We'd like to leave you with these photographs because honestly, if ever you feel like going backwards, say, get the photographs out. Please, please, work as a team.
I gotta thank my daughter April, like, for getting us into this mess. Mm-hmm. Actually getting us
out of the mess.
Thank you, April.
They've done it, haven't they?
The good family just got better.
You go, oh yeah, I'll second that.
Let's go.
Before they came, it was either me or the dogs. But now, it's me and the dogs.
I'm studying for tests better. I'm doing my homework a lot more now. And as a result, my marks are a lot better.
I think the family unit has teamed up. My house is organized. My children are thinking things through logically to help me. And I love them all.